Amina? Speak up, Tarun.
Yes, ma'am.
Where were you when I called your name?
मैम वो आवाज पता नहीं कट रही थी अब तो ठीक आ रही है.
Okay, I have marked for all these. Let me check for Ishita. Ishita, I must have marked for you. No, not yet. You must haven't. Are you present, Ishika? Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Ronak, I have marked for you. Same for Mohit. All right. Let's start our class. Let me set it my camera on the board. Okay. Take out your copies till then. Yes, Ronak, are you having any doubt? Okay, you have lowered down your hand. Yeah, Sakshi Sharma, I must have marked your present and two. Let me check, Sakshi. Yes, Sakshi Sharma, your Manali Rupani. Let me mark your present, Manali. I haven't marked as you. I don't got the response earlier from you, Manali. Good morning, Ronak. Shant Sharma, copy check nahi hui. Which copy is not checked, Shant? Ishant, you may submit your copy again as I don't know why they haven't provided me your copy. Okay. Jo bhi copies mere paas ghar par aayi hain, I have checked them. All right. Yogesh Yogi was entering into the class.
Meri mil gayi.
This WhatsApp test paper?
No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
WhatsApp test paper, you must have submitted over there, na? Class teachers have taken.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. I'll check your copies later on. Right now, I'm doing for 9th only. I have started with 9th. Okay. After I'll do yours. But we haven't got all the copies yet. So those who haven't submitted, they can submit it today. Okay. Still, the students are entering. Again and again, I have to open the attendance sheet. From next class, I'm not going to mark present. Those who will come after 8:10, 8:15. Okay. Now, if anybody will come, I'm not going to mark the present for them. All right. So, let's start with the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay. Is there anyone who is sitting in a peaceful environment and I can unmute him or her? Is there any student? Perfectly peaceful environment. He or she is sitting. Okay, so many are there. All right, so I would like to unmute Pawan.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, Pawan. Thank you. Is the board visible, Pawan?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. The whole board?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am. Ma'am, the lower dikh nahi raha. Yes, ma'am, I'm saying.
Now it's okay, perfectly fine, Anna. Your videos, everyone. We are going to discuss about the physical properties. Of metals and non-metals, okay? Start writing along with me, everyone. Pick out your copies, pens. Sit up straight. Are you guys are feeling lazy? Sit up straight. Are you still feeling sleepy? All right. The first property that we are talking about is the physical states. If I talk about the physical state, then metals are mostly solids, okay? But exceptions are everywhere. In each and only exceptions, may say questions bante hain, mostly remember this thing, okay? So you have to learn the exceptions also, all right? So most of the metals are solid at room temperature. And non-metals ki agar main baat karu, then wo generally gaseous state mein bhi hote hain aur solid state mein bhi hote hain. If I talk about the exception, then mercury. All of us are aware that mercury is the only metal which is liquid at room temperature, and due to this quality of mercury, it is used into the thermometer to measure the body temperature. Okay, but as it is poisonous, it's not good for our health. So government has banned the use of mercury nowadays. All right. So mercury is the exception. If I talk about non-metals, then mostly तो ये solid या gaseous stage के अंदर होते हैं, लेकिन bromine सिर्फ एक ऐसा नॉन मेटल है जो कि लिक्विड स्टेट में एग्जिस्ट करता है. ओके, मैं राइट लिक्विड इन द ब्रैकेट.
And here I'm just writing E exception. I'm not writing the whole word exception over here. Okay. Bromine B R से denote करते हैं, right? ये किस स्टेज में होता है? Like, okay? Just because of this quality, you can use the metal articles very comfortably for preparing food, etc. They are good conductors also. They are in solid state also. So we can use them for making utensils and jewelry. Okay. Now let's come towards the second point. It is the malleability. If I talk about malleability, then what is malleability? That which allows the metal to be hammered into thin sheets. जिससे कि आप पतली पतली sheets बना सकते हो. Okay? May write, make sheets. Okay? जिस भी metal को non-metal को आप hammer करके and if you can make sheets from them, that is being known as their malleability. Okay, so metals are malleable. If I talk about aluminium, it is. Okay, that's why you must have observed the aluminium. You must have observed the aluminium foil on the tablets. Anna, tablets ke upar ye wo kya hoti hai? Aluminium foil. We use the aluminium foil to the chapatis also. To wrap the food stuff also, okay? So just because of this quality, you can use them in these different things. Gold, silver, aluminium, copper, ये सब highly malleable metals हैं, okay? और इसीलिए ये बहुत ज़्यादा useful आते हैं chocolates को pack करने में, medicines को pack करने में, okay? So you can write it over here, highly brittle means when I'm going to hammer it, what will happen? It will not work into sheets, but it will get broken into smaller pieces. So that is known as the brittleness. I'm repeating myself. What is brittleness? कि जब मैं उसको hammer करूँगी, then it will not get converted into sheet, but it will be broken into small pieces. So that is known as the brittleness. So zinc is the only metal which is brittle. Otherwise, all the other metals are highly malleable. They could be changed into sheets. Okay? If I talk about non-metal, they are not malleable. Okay? They cannot be beaten into thin sheets. If agar aap unko hammer bhi karoge, to aap usse thin sheets nahi bana sakte. Wo chote-chote pieces mein toot jayenge. Qualities. It is known as the brittleness. Okay, so I can say that the non-metals are generally brittle. Okay, agar main coal ki baat karun, all of you must have seen the coal. Koila sabne dekha hoga. Kya hoga? Agar aap usko hammer karoge, what will happen if you will hammer it? Obviously, it will get broken into smaller pieces. Usse koi patli sheet to nahi banegi. Okay. So that is known as the brittleness. Okay, आप coal का example ले लो, sulphur का example ले लो, कोई भी example ले लो, gases भी होती हैं non-metals में, okay, oxygen, hydrogen, कोई भी ले लीजिए. तो these are brittle in nature, okay, and some are in liquid state. As I told you, bromine तो liquid state में ही होता है, then how it's possible to make cheese from them? Alright. So they are not malleable, they are having brittle in nature. Okay? Now I think I can rub the upper part. You guys must started writing along with me. Those who have not started it yet, please start it. As I'm not going to provide you any written notes. Yahi hai notes jo main aapko provide kar rahi hu on board. Okay. Next, I'm going to discuss with the ductility. Right yet. Okay, what I mean by this one, let it get right. Till then, I'll explain. What I mean by this word ductility. Ductility means which could be converted into thin wires. Okay, so जिनसे पतली पतली वायर्स बनाई जा सकती है वो मेटल्स के वो प्रॉपर्टी जिससे कि वो उनसे थिन वायर्स बनाई जा सकती है दैट इज नोन एज डक्टिलिटी. ओके सो गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर आर अमंग द बेस्ट डक्टाइल मटेरियल राइट. गोल्ड और सिल्वर से इसके बाद आता है कॉपर एल्युमिनियम के इन सब से आप वायरिंग बना सकते हैं बट एज वी नो दैट सिल्वर इज अ लिटिल बिट एक्सपेंसिव. That's as the silver is also a very good conductor, but we are not using it for making bulb, etc. Just because of this quality, that metals could be changed into wires, we are using them into the electricity purposes, right? Which is ke andar aapne observe kiya hoga na, copper ki thin wires rehti hai. Why? Because they are having this property of ductility. Ductility means change into, drawn into thin wires. Make them wires. So highly ductile, I can say for metal. And if I talk about this non-metal, what about non-metal? Are they ductile? Can be drawn into thin wires? No, definitely not. Okay? Aap jab non-metals ko स्ट्रेच करोगे कोई भी हो चाहे वो गोल्ड हो चाहे वो सिल्वर हो चाहे वो स्मॉलर्स हो दे विल ब्रेक इनटू पीसेस. ओके एज दे आर ब्रिटल इन नेचर सो यू कैन नॉट मेक वायर्स फ्रॉम देम. ऑब्वियसली जो ब्रिटल नेचर का है देन हाउ इट्स पॉसिबल फॉर यू टू मेक वायर्स फ्रॉम देम. सो दे आर नॉन डक्टाइल. ओके they are non ductile. Now let's discuss about the luster. Luster means the shine, and as we know most of the metals are having luster with them. Just because of this property of metals, the gold, silver, etc. are used for making jewelries. Okay, they are being used for jewelry purpose just because of their shine, their luster. Okay, so mostly metals are lustrous. शाइनी सरफेस होती है जिससे कि वो अच्छे रिफ्लेक्टर्स भी होते हैं है ना. कोई भी शाइनी सरफेस है तो जब उस पर लाइट पड़ेगी तो वो अच्छे रिफ्लेक्टर्स होंगे. ओके सो जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस प्रॉपर्टी उनको ज्वेलरी मेकिंग के लिए डेकोरेटिव आर्टिकल्स के लिए यूज किया जाता है. ओके एंड इवन ग्लासेस के पीछे भी ग्लास मिरर्स के पीछे भी थिन कोटिंग लगाते हैं हम मेटल्स की राइट. सिल्वर पॉलिश की जाती है सिल्वर मेटल लगाया जाता है या फिर अल्यूमिनियम एट देयर बैक जिससे कि वो अच्छे रिफ्लेक्टर्स बन पाते. ओके सो इफ एनीबडी इज आस्किंग यू दैट व्हाई द अल्यूमिनियम और सिल्वर शीट इज बीइंग पेस्टेड एट द बैक साइड ऑफ द ग्लास मिरर सो यू मे आंसर बिकॉज दे आर द गुड रिफ्लेक्टर्स दैट्स व्हाई दे आर बीइंग यूज्ड सो दैट the proper image should be there after getting reflected. Okay, so if I talk about luster, they are having a good luster. Okay, you can say lustrous. But non-metals are non-lustrous. They are not having any shine with them. But exceptions are there. They are dull in appearance. They can be graphite or iodine. Mein thoda sa shine hota hai. Okay, here we are having the exception. Graphite, all of you must have seen in your pencil. What is the exception? Graphite, I was telling. Graphite, jo ki aapko apni pencils pe likhte hain, along with this, iodine. So, agar aap apni pencil ko sharp karenge, then what you will observe, the front part is a little bit shiny. Okay, so graphite is a metal, then too it is having a little bit luster with it. Alright, so that is the exception over there. Now let's discuss about the next property. For that I have to rub this first one, the physical state. Please keep on writing along with me. I'm again and again telling you. I'm not going to provide any PDF. All of you have to write along with me. Sit with your rough copy. Copy mein kaam pura nahi hai, rough copy lekar baithi. I'm not having any issue with that. You may do your work later on. But complete your work quickly. As after checking these test copies, we are going to ask you for the regular copies. As you know, you are having 5 marks for that also. Okay? Conductivity. Of heat. You know, metals are highly conductible. They are having the conductivity. They can conduct heat. That's why they are being used for utensil purposes. You must have observed your mother preparing food in the metal articles. Okay? Metal utensils. So why? Because they are good conductors of heat. Unse heat jaldi transfer ho jati hai. Okay? अगर मैं सिल्वर की बात करूं, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया था, सिल्वर इज द बेस्ट कंडक्टर ऑफ हीट एज वेल एज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. और उसके बाद आता है नंबर कॉपर का. इसलिए हम वायर्स को सिल्वर का ना बना के कॉपर का बना. ओके, बिकॉज़ सिल्वर इज एक्सपेंसिव, सो वी डू नॉट यूज सिल्वर फॉर वायरिंग पर्पसेस. वी कैन नॉट यूज सिल्वर फॉर वायरिंग पर्पसेस, सो वी यूज दिस कॉपर. एल्यूमिनियम की बात करूं, आयरन की बात करूं, और अदर गुड कंडक्टर्स ऑफ हीट. यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड एल्यूमिनियम यूटेंसिल्स आल्सो इन योर किचन. ओके, इसीलिए इन सारों को वाटर बॉयलर्स और यूटेंसिल्स में यूज किया जाता है. ओके, सो गुड कंडक्टर्स यू मे राइट. एक्सेप्शन लिख लीजिए, बिस्मिथ. Okay, bismuth is a poor conductor of heat. It's not good conductor. Okay, besides being a metal, it's not good conductor. Non-metals, obviously, they are poor conductor of heat. Okay, you may write poor conductors. But if I talk about exception, exceptions are always there. And what is the exception for this? Yes, diamond, which is the hardest substance among the non-metals. Okay? Diamond is the only non-metal which exists in the solid form. And I think I forgot to write the exception. It's the first physical property. Please write it down over there, the exception for diamond. And it's the good conductor. All the non-metals are poor conductor except diamond. Okay. Now, the next property is their hardness. Obviously, we know all the metals are hard. We have touched iron articles, we have touched aluminium, copper, all of them are hard, right? I'm wrapping this, as I hope all of you must have done. Okay, so metals generally hard hote hain. Iron ki baat karu, aluminium ki baat karu, sare metals hard hote hain. ठीक है एंड इसीलिए आप इनको आयरन वगैरह को आप कहाँ यूज करते हो जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मेटल्स दैट दे आर हार्ड दे आर बीइंग यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग द रेलिंग्स दे आर बीइंग यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग ब्रिजेस दे आर बीइंग यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मशीन्स राइट बॉडी बनती है अगर मैं ऑटोमोबाइल्स की बात करूँ आयरन की बॉडी होती है राइट अगर मैं रेलवे लाइंस की बात करूं, they are also made up of the metals, iron. If I talk about bridges, yes, bridges में भी use किया जाता है iron sheets को to give them more strength. Okay, so they are hard in nature generally. Okay. Why the students are entering by this time? I cannot understand. Generally, I'm telling you their uses, but I'm not writing the uses over here. Okay. See, exceptions as I told you are always there. So here the exception is sodium, potassium, जिनको आप knife से भी cut कर सकते हो. Sodium, which is denoted by Na, which is the Latin name of sodium. Sodium is natrium. And another one is potassium, and the Latin name potassium is kalium, and it is denoted with K. Both of these sodium potassium are not hard, and they could be cutted with knife only. Okay, उनको आप चाकू से भी काट सकते हो. All right. Non-metals, they are not strong क्योंकि वो होते ही gaseous state में हैं कई बार solid में भी होते हैं gaseous में भी होते हैं and liquid state में भी होता है as if bromine okay so how they could be hard they are not hard they are not strong alright you can break them by hammering कुछ भी उनके ऊपर रखोगे they will break but as I told you Diamond is the hardest substance among all the non-metals. So here again, the diamond will come as an exception. They are generally not hard, but diamond is the exception among them. Okay, diamond is the exception. I'm going to love the third property. Please keep on writing along with me. Yes, Manali, you have raised your hand. Are you having any doubt? Manali Rupani, you may unmute yourself. Yes, Manali. Yes, Manali. Who is this with the name Dinesh Soni? I'm not having any student with this name.
प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ.
मैम वो मेरे पापा का नाम आ रहा है और रीनेम भी नहीं हो रहा है. ऑप्शन आ नहीं रहा.
नेम व्हाट्स योर नेम?
दिव्या सोनी.
यू शुड चेक बिफोर एंटरिंग इनटू द क्लास बेटा.
और मैम मेरी आज लेट क्लास ज्वाइन हुई थी तो मेरी प्रेजेंट टू गई क्या?
Why you were late in class? Can you tell?
Network की problem हो रही थी.
That's good. Everybody is having this excuse. Why I'm not having this network issue sometimes? Why I don't feel that? Can you guys tell please? Teacher को क्यों नहीं होती है? वो कैसे time पे पहुंच जाते हैं बेटा? एक दिन मैं हाफ एन आवर लेट हो जाऊंगा एंड आई विल गिव यू दिस एक्सक्यूज. हाउ डू गाइस विल बी हैप्पी नो. ओके जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट वंस. ऑलराइट सो नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ. Lower down your hand, dear. Okay. So now I'm going to talk about tensile strength. You know what I mean by this word tensile strength? जिससे कि आप उसको कितना भी hammer करो, कुछ भी करो, वो सारा strain जो है वो सहन कर लेगा. ठीक है? सहन शक्ति जिसको आप बोलते हैं. Okay. So the property which allows a substance to bear a lot of strain without breaking. टूटता नहीं है और टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ दैट मींस उसकी ज्यादा होगी. अब आप जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. आपको पता है मेलिबिलिटी मेटल्स में होती है, डक्टिलिटी मेटल्स में होती है. नॉन मेटल्स आर नॉट हैविंग मेलिबिलिटी एंड डक्टिलिटी. इफ दे विल बी हैविंग हायर टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ देन दे वुड बी हैविंग मेलिबिलिटी एंड डक्टिलिटी आल्सो. राइट? अगर उनमें टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ होती, अगर वो हैमर करने पर टूटते नहीं, तो आप उनसे वायर्स भी बना सकते और शीट्स भी बना सकते. जब उनसे वायर्स और शीट्स नहीं बन रही, इफ दे आर नॉट मेलिएबल, इफ दे आर नॉट डक्टाइल, देन हाउ दे कुड बी हैविंग टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ? सो यू कैन टेल दैट मेटल्स आर हैविंग गुड टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ. राइट? दे कैन बेयर अ लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेन विदाउट ब्रेकिंग. दैट्स व्हाई दे आर बीइंग यूज्ड फॉर डिफरेंट पर्पसेस. शीट्स आर मेड फॉर देम. राइट? ब्रिजेस वगैरह में इसीलिए तो यूज होता है, रेलवे लाइन में इसीलिए तो यूज होता है. तो इसी भी टूटता नहीं है. दे आर हैविंग हाई टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ. ओके सो राइट अबाउट हियर. राइट द एक्सेप्शन. Zinc is not having high tensile strength. If you will hammer it, it will get broken, poor jaega. It's not having high tensile strength. And if I talk about net non-metals, they are also not having high tensile strength. तो उनके भी लोग low होती है, easily टूट जाते हैं. ठीक है? Exceptions are always there. What's the time? Let me check the time. All right, it's 8:53. So let me complete these physical properties and the chemical properties we will discuss in our next class. And just one or two points are more remaining for this. Okay. Alright, so I was telling you about the tensile strength and the carbon fibers are the exception. Uh-huh.
I'm going to rub this luster as well as the productivity. The next one, the 8th, is density. क्योंकि मिर्च जो ज़्यादा denser होगा, that means वो hard भी होगा. Dense means density means क्या होता है? In which the particles are very close to one another. See, if I'm having two rooms with me, in the first room I'm having strength of 50 students. Okay, and another room with the same area. See, the area is the same. But I'm having only 20 students in that room. So कहाँ पर density ज़्यादा हुई? Density means per unit area में how many students are present in per unit area. Okay, so that is the density. So if I talk about matter, they are having high densities. Okay, metals are having high densities with them. But if I talk about non-metals, no, they are not having good densities. Okay, non-metals, sodium, potassium, I have told you that they could be cut with knife, right? We have given the example of sodium, potassium over here. And why they are being cut from knife? Because they are not too hard. They are not, their particles are not too close. They are not having high densities, that's why they could be cut with knives. So here, for high densities, you can give the exception. Again, for sodium and potassium, I'm not writing the whole name, I'm just writing their symbols. This is sodium and this is potassium. Its Latin name is lithium and it is carium. Okay, sodium and potassium. Alright, and if I talk about non-metals, yes, they are having the low densities. But as we know, diamond is everywhere as an exception, as it is the hardest non-metal. Okay, it's hard, so it must be having high density. That's why it is hard. So just give the exception of diamond over here. Alright. Now conductivity and electricity. Conductivity of heat we have discussed. Conductivity of electricity. Yes, we know that they are highly conductible. That's why they are having high conductivity. That's why we use them for making wires and for electricity purposes, because they are good conductors. Okay. But exceptions are always there, as you know. Okay, silver सबसे अच्छा conductor है, as I told you, and after that copper. Okay, so we use copper because silver is a little bit expensive. All right, so copper wires are being used in household articles. Aluminium wires are used in electric cables. Okay, क्योंकि copper and aluminium both are good conductors of electricity. Non-metals poor conductor होते हैं, but graphite is a exception. Okay, sulfur, phosphorus, ये सारे poor conductors हैं, but graphite. What is graphite, which is present in your pencils? Okay, that is a good conductor. So you may give the exception for graphite. Is graphite is the exception for this. Okay. All right. Two more points I'm having: sonority and MP and BP. So that I'll discuss in my next class as conductivity.